We see the bottom case for the MacBook Pro 14-inch 2021 model. The same steps apply to the 16-inch model. We're using an ESD safe workstation, including an ESD safe mat, a black stick, a fine tip permanent marker, a pentalobe screwdriver, a suction cup, and optional cut resistant gloves. Using a pentalobe screwdriver, remove the four identical short screws from the front of the bottom case. Then, remove the four identical long pentalobe screws at the rear of the bottom case. The bottom case has four clips inside that need to be disengaged. So place your suction cup on one side and gently lift until the case is released from the clips. Then do the same on the other side. Insert the black stick in the gap between the display and top case. Pull the black stick to disengage the top case from the bottom case. Lift and remove the bottom case. Feel free to wear cut-resistant gloves as an option. If you are only replacing the bottom case, then use a fine tip permanent marker to write the serial number on the inside of the replacement bottom case. Then, go to the reassembly instructions. If you are performing an additional repair, attach the protective battery cover and disconnect the battery as follows. Use a Torx T3 screwdriver to remove the two trackpad cowling screws. Using tweezers, remove the cowling. Then, using a black stick, disconnect the trackpad flex cable. Using tweezers, gently peel up the Mylar on the BMU flex cable. Then, using a black stick, gently lift up the lever to unlock the BMU flex cable. Now, using the pointed end of the black stick, disconnect the BMU flex cable. Loosen the adhesive under the cable and peel up the cable to reveal the battery screw. Gently lift the trackpad flex cable out of the way if needed. Using a Torx T5 screwdriver, remove the T5 battery screw, then complete any additional repair. After the repair is complete, reinstall the T5 screw. Then, press along the length of the cable to adhere it to the BMU screw and logic board. Reconnect the BMU flex cable using ESD safe tweezers. Flip down the locking lever, then press the Mylar tab to the locking lever. Now press the end of the trackpad flex cable to the connector on the logic board. Then reinstall the trackpad cowling and two T3 screws. Remove the battery cover and proceed with reassembly. For reassembly, gently slide the bottom case so the spring fingers engage with the top case and the screw holes align. To allow a better hold on the case, use a pair of cut-resistant gloves to push down and forward toward the back of the notebook. Using your fingers, lift the front edge of the bottom case no more than 1 inch high, 25 millimeters. This aligns the thermal fan ducts. Four clips inside the bottom case attach to the top case. Press both sides of the bottom case simultaneously until you feel the clips snap into place. Reinstall the four longer pentalobe screws on the rear of the bottom case. Then, reinstall the four shorter pentalobe screws on the front of the bottom case. The bottom case is affixed now, and you're done. To verify a successful repair, run the appropriate field diagnostics as connected the battery and remove the vent antenna module. Let's look at the tools needed for this procedure. We're using a battery cover, an ESD safe workstation, including an ESD safe mat, ESD safe tweezers, a Torx T3, Torx T5, and a Torx T6 screwdriver, and a black stick. The next step is to disconnect all the flex cables around the logic board. Most of them are protected by cowlings, which you can easily remove. Work clockwise around the board. Start in the upper right-hand corner and use the Torx T3 screwdriver to remove the two T3 screws and cowling over the lid angle sensor. Using a black stick, disconnect the lid angle sensor flex cable. Remove the two T3 screws and cowling. Using a black stick, disconnect the MagSafe Flex cable. Now, remove the three T3 screws and cowling. Use the black stick to disconnect the two USB-C flex cables. Move on to removing the two T3 screws and cowling. Use the black stick to disconnect the audio jack flex cable. Using ESD safe tweezers, gently peel up the Mylar cover, release the locking lever, and use the pointed end of a black stick to pull and disconnect the speaker flex cable. Near the audio jack flex cable is the tri-mic flex cable. Use tweezers to peel the Mylar cover. Release the locking lever and use the pointed end of a black stick to pull and disconnect the tri-mic flex cable. Using ESD safe tweezers, gently peel up the Mylar cover and release the locking lever using a black stick. Please note there is a fair amount of adhesive on this cable, so use the tweezers to slowly release the cable adhesive. Use open, flat-headed tweezers to carefully release the adhesive bond between the fan cable and the board. A black stick is too thick and can cause damage. The next two flex cables towards the center don't have cowlings, but they do have locking levers. Using ESD safe tweezers, gently peel up the Mylar covers. Release the locking levers for the keyboard backlight and keyboard flex cables. Use the pointed end of a black stick to pull and disconnect the cables. Using ESD safe tweezers, gently peel up the Mylar cover. Release the locking lever using a black stick. Like the other fan flex cable, there is a fair amount of adhesive on this cable, so use the tweezers to slowly release the cable adhesive. For the next speaker flex cable, use ESD safe tweezers to gently peel up the Mylar cover, release the locking lever using a black stick, and disconnect the flex cable. Moving to the next cowling, remove the two T3 screws and use a black stick to disconnect the USB-C flex cable. In the upper left-hand corner, remove the two T3 screws and cowling. Use a black stick to disconnect the Touch ID flex cable. Be aware of the adhesive on this particular flex cable. Proceed with caution. The last two cowlings are at the top center of the board. Remove the two T3 screws and cowling. Use a black stick to disconnect the backlight flex cable. The T-Con flex cable screws were removed with the vent antenna. Use your fingers or a black stick to lift up the T-Con flex cables. Next, remove the two T3 screws and cowling. Use a black stick to disconnect the camera flex cable and the EDP flex cables. Use your fingers or a black stick to lift up the T-Con flex cables. With all the flex cables detached, it's now time to remove the logic board screws. Overall, the logic board is secured using 11 T5 screws and 3 T6 screws. Let's start with the 3 T6 screws. Remove the 3 T6 screws. Two of these are located on either side of the logic board. The third T6 screw is just below the audio jack flex cable. Moving to the bottom of the logic board on either side of the BMU flex cable, remove the four identical T5 screws. Now, let's remove the six T5 screws that surround the fans. Note that the two screws on the outside of the fans are longer. The screws on the inside of the fans are shorter. And finally, there was one last T5 screw near the triangle mic. With all the flex cables released and logic board screws removed, it's time to remove the logic board. It is strongly suggested that you use Kapton tape to gently secure the flex cables out of the way. Do this to avoid any pinching or pulling from the logic board removal. To prevent cable damage, don't bend them farther than 90 degrees. This protects cables and makes it easier to handle the logic board. Pay special attention to the Touch ID cable. Don't tape this cable. Keep the Kapton tape in place until the logic board is reinstalled. Use a black stick to gently loosen the corner of the logic board. Then slide out the logic board at an angle, like this. Gently shift cables out of the way as you remove the logic board from the top case. For reassembly, it is recommended that you use Kapton tape to ensure the flex cables and thermal ducts are out of the way and won't interfere with installation of the logic board. Do not bend the cables back too far, as this could damage them. Tilt one side of the logic board into the top case, focusing on the left side first. Use a black stick and fingers to clear cables from the edges of the board so none are pinched. With the board settled into place, count all the cables to make sure they are near their connectors and not caught under the board. Although it will be reconnected during final reassembly, add the BMU flex cable to your count. Adjust the board to align screw holes. Remove the Kapton tape from the cables and thermal ducts. Begin by reinstalling the three T6 screws. Now install the 11 T5 screws. Please note that the two screws on the outside of the fans are longer. The screws on the inside of the fans are shorter. Working in a counterclockwise direction, reconnect the cables and reinstall their cowlings and screws. Refer to the service guide for final reassembly and recalibration instructions. Also note that after system configuration is completed on a replacement logic board, the repair cannot be reversed. This means that the previously installed logic board cannot be reused in the same unit. Today we're going to watch how to remove and replace the Touch ID board. As you can see, the Touch ID board has a unique cable shape and adhesive backing. The flex cable for the MacBook Pro 16-inch model is longer than the 14-inch model. Make sure you have all the tools on hand and that you've completed the initial steps. The steps for both models are similar. There are differences due to the location inside the top case. There is also a difference in the Touch ID cable routing between models. For this procedure, we'll focus on the MacBook Pro 14-inch model. To reach the Touch ID board for this model, we've already removed the vent antenna module, clutch covers, display, and logic board. Refer to the service guide for your specific model. A difference between units concerns a rubber cover found on the MacBook Pro 16-inch model. The 14-inch model doesn't have this part. Remove the black rubber cover adhered to the Touch ID board cowling. For the 16-inch model, peel the Touch ID board flex cable from the top case. For the 14-inch model, keep in mind that the Touch ID flex cable has a fair amount of adhesive and is attached to a Y-shaped cowling. For the 14-inch model, use tweezers to peel the Touch ID board flex cable off the Y-shaped cowling. For the rest of this procedure, the steps are very similar, and we'll focus on the 14-inch model. Then, remove two T3 screws from the Y-shaped cowling. Remove the cowling and set it aside for reuse. Use the Torx T3 screwdriver to remove the six T3 screws from the Touch ID board cowling. Note and remember the orientation of the cowling for reinstallation. Then remove the cowling from the top case. Lift up the computer while guiding the Touch ID flex cable through the slot in the top case. Set aside the top case. Place the computer upright and thread the replacement Touch ID board flex cable clip through the top case. Keep the protective film on the flex cable and button for now. Lay the computer flat, top case facing up. Make sure the flex cable is tucked under the computer to avoid pinching the Touch ID flex cable. Remove the blue protective cover on the top of the button. Set two Y-shaped alignment tools in the top case opening and place the tabs in the corner edge. Secure the tools with Kapton tape and press the Touch ID button into the square opening. Now, flip the top case over, and set the keyboard side down flat on the ESD mat. Using tweezers, reinstall the Touch ID board cowling so that the keyed side fits the Touch ID cable. Be sure it is installed right side up, or the button may not function properly. Note that the two center screws in the Touch ID board are shorter than the screws in the corners. Use the T3 screwdriver to reinstall the four outer T3 screws. Then, partially reinstall the two middle T3 screws. Next, flip the top case over and press the Touch ID button to ensure that you can feel it click. Once you've verified the button clicks, flip over the top case and fully tighten the two middle screws. Flip the top case over again, being careful not to pinch the Touch ID flex cable. Then, ensure that the Touch ID button still clicks when pressed. Remove the tape and alignment tools and look at the Touch ID button to verify that all the sides are spaced equally. If not, loosen the screws and start the alignment process again. If the button has equal spaces, we're almost done. Now, flip the notebook over to complete the installation of the Y-shaped cowling. Reinstall the Y-shaped cowling and two T3 screws. If you're installing a replacement Touch ID, remove the blue protective film and affix it to the Y-shaped cowling. If reinstalling the same Touch ID board, re-adhere the cable. Recheck that the Touch ID button clicks. If the button doesn't click or move, refer to the service guide for shim instructions. Leave the blue protective film on the end of the Touch ID flex cable until you reinstall the logic board. As a final step, consult the service guide for reassembly and configuration details. If you replace the logic board, you must also replace the Touch ID board. But if you reinstall the same logic board, you don't need to replace the Touch ID.